Hello and welcome to another episode. My name is Christian from BitBranding, and today we're going to go over how to manage your inventory in Shopify. First thing you want to do is head over to products, and then inside of products, you'll see this drop-down list. You may have already added some of the products, and I've already created these products with inventory in mind. So think of inventory as, you know, you have physical goods, and these physical goods live in a storage, maybe your garage, maybe you have an actual, you know, facility that handles a lot of these things. But you want to make sure that you track in the inventory, because Shopify automatically deducts inventory based off of when someone purchases a product. So that part is automatic. What's not automatic is actually adding inventory into your store. So I'm just going to walk through really quickly how to do that. Now, if you see here, the Colorful Bones already have a 12 inventory, 12 in stock as far as inventory. Now, if I click on that and scroll down here to the bottom, you'll see that under inventory, I have a check mark to track inventory. And then the quantity, I have 12 available. If you have variance, and then we can go ahead and add that right here. So you'll see, maybe we sell this by the bag. So maybe small, medium, and large. Now, because we did that and we only had 12 in inventory, it will just assign it to that first one. So let's say maybe we just have six of these, we have six of these and six of these, and hit save. That's how you add inventory and add inventory to your variance at the same time. If you don't have variance, then all you have to worry about is just the regular inventory. Now, when it comes to changing some of these, once you have your variance set up, then you just hit on the arrows up and down to let it know that you have new shipments or more quantity of that particular item. Now I'm going to go ahead and save that. And I'm going to show you, when you create brand new products. So I add a new product. You would go through the same process of adding the name, description, images, pricing, and things like that. Now, when it comes to inventory here, this will probably be already automatically checked for you. Track quantity. If you don't want to track quantity, obviously you would just uncheck that. But when you click on track quantity, it gives you the option for you to add the quantity that you have on hand. Another thing, if you receive shipments pretty often, then you can probably checkmark this one, which is continues to sell the products even when they're out of stock from your Shopify store. Maybe you're during a busy season, you actually have shipments coming in, and you know that you will have these shipments coming in, then you can probably checkmark that, because you'll probably be able to turn those orders around pretty quickly. That's about it. Once you click on track quantity, the quantity will be there. Now, just like I said previously, if you add the variance, this product has multiple options like different sizes or colors, then you would have to do that individually for each variant. So we did the size. Maybe we can change this to color, and we have blue, red, and green. And it works the same way as before. You would have to manually come in here and change the quantity of those variants within here. And that's it. You just save the product, and I'm gonna cancel out of that, or discard that new product, discard changes. And then here at a glance, you'll be able to see, and Shopify is kind of cool because it shows you on yellow that you're running low in stock for this particular item. And it will just show you right here within the inventory. If you're not tracking the inventory, it will just show you an NA so that you're not tracking inventory for that particular item. And you can also go to the inventory tab over here. And if you deal with large and volumes of different products and different things like that, you can just go straight to inventory and add your inventories as they come in, essentially. So you can add, let's say you're getting 20 of these, you can click on save, and it'll switch it to, you have those available. Now, when it comes to those variants, it will break it down here to small, large, medium, on those variants, so you can add those individually within the inventory tab. So the inventory tab is very useful if you have a large amount of product within your store. So that's it. Very important to keep track of your inventory, just to make sure that you don't sell out. And like I said, Shopify automatically takes care of deducting those items once people actually purchase on your store. Thank you for watching this tutorial on how to manage your inventory within your Shopify store. If you enjoyed this episode or want to learn a little bit more about inventory tracking, then let me know in the comments down below. Also, leave a like on our video and subscribe if you enjoyed this and you want to learn more about Shopify, as we'll be releasing new videos on Shopify on our channel. Thank you.